Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fit and fine. So dear students, as you know that we are revising the syllabus according to your revision test. So in your next revision test in literature, the proposal chapter 11 is there. So today we are going to discuss chapter 11, the proposal. So first of all, we will go through the summary, short summary of the chapter, and then we will discuss questions from last year's board examination. Okay, so let's begin. Let me show you the revision note on your screen and go through that. Later I will show you the questions which are asked in various CBSE board examination and other also important questions which are expected. So let's begin. First of all, we are going to discuss extract based questions. They are asked in the examination for 3 marks. Read the following extracts carefully and answer the questions that follow. Question number 1. What are you talking about? Auction medals are ours, not yours. Question number 1. Who is the speaker here? So we all know Natalia is the speaker here. Who is being referred to by yours? So Lomo is being referred by yours here. Find a word from the extract which means a piece of grassland. So that is meadows. Meadows means a piece of grassland. Who is being referred to as ours? So ours is referred Natalia and his father. Natalia and her father, not his. This is misprinting. It should be, this is typing error. It should be her. Okay, so ours referred Natalia and her father. Question number 2. Hear me out, I implore you. The peasants of your father's grandfather, as I have already had the honor, already have the honor of explaining to you, used to bake bricks for my aunt's grandmother. Now my aunt's grandmother wishing to make them a present. Let us go through the questions and their answers. Question number A. Who is the speaker here? So Lomo is the speaker here. What did the peasants do? So the peasants used to bake bricks for Lomo's aunt's grandmother. C. Find the exact word from the extract which means to ask something in a very serious way. So that is implore. From the extract means to ask something in a very serious way. What is the synonym of high respect in the extract? So the word honor means high respect. Now question number 3. You may take it that I know whether I have the right or not, because the young man, I'm not used to being spoken to in that tone of voice and so on. I, young man, I'm twice your age and ask you to speak to me without hesitating yourself and all that. Who is the speaker here? So Chubuko, Natalia's father, is the speaker here. How did the speaker wanted Lomo to talk to him? So Chubuko wanted Lomo to speak to him without hesitating himself. Find the word from the extract which means to disturb, excite or anger someone. So that is hesitating. Hesitating means from the extract to disturb, excite or anger someone. Question number 4. Never mind about my people. The Lomos have been honorable people and not one has ever been tried for embezzlement like your grandfather. So who does the speaker say the above lines to? Yes, the speaker Lomo said the above lines to Chubuko. To Chubuko, find the word from the extract which means theft of funds. So that is embezzlement. From the extract means theft of funds. Explain, never mind about my people. So Lomo said this line because of his family members. Okay, it shows that he did not want Chubuko and Natalia to say anything about his family. Question number 5. It has also been asked in CBSE examination 2014. Natalia, what proposal? Chubuko, why? He came here to propose to you. Natalia, to propose to me. Why didn't you tell me so before? Chubuko, so he dresses up in evening clothes. The stuffed sauces. The virgin faced man from. So who is being referred to as he here? So Lomo is being referred to as he in the extract. B. Why did he meet Chubuko? So Lomo met Chubuko's to ask for Natalia's hand. He went there to propose Natalia. Find the word from the extract which means make an offer of marriage to someone. So propose from the extract means make an offer of marriage to someone. Who was dressed in as a stuffed sausage? So Lomo was dressed as a stuffed sausage. Short answer type questions, 2 marks each. Question number 1. Which qualities are common in all 3 characters of the play, The Proposal? So all the characters in the play are argumentative, full of pride, possessiveness. They are always ready to argue for petty things. Question number 2. Why does Lomo come to Chubuko's house? What for does he come? How is he received? It has also been asked in CBSE examination 2012. So Lomo came to Chubuko's house in the evening dress with gloves on. it is not Keynes, it is a mistake in print in typing. He came to propose, or you can also write he comes, okay? He comes to propose to his daughter Natalia. He is received with all the respect by Chubuko. Question number 3. How does Chubuko react when Natalia says that he has come to ask for the hand of his daughter? When Lomo says that he has come to ask for the hand of his daughter, Chubuko gets off balanced and joy. He embraces and kisses Lomo, sheds a tear of joy and calls for God's blessing for Lomo and Natalia. Why did Lomo want to get married? Lomo wanted to get, it should be get here, get married, as he was already 35 years old. Moreover, he was suffering due to a weak heart and sleep sickness and wanted company of someone to look after him. Question number 5. What happens to Lomo when he is in an excited state? So when Lomo is in an excited state, his heartbeat increases, lips tremble, and there is a twitch in his right eyebrow. When he goes to sleep in such a state, something pulls him from his left side and he jumps like a lunatic. Question number 6. How does Natalia excite Lomo for the point of verbal fighting? Natalia repeatedly insisted that oxen meadows are theirs and told Lomo that up to now she considered Lomo as a good neighbor and friend. This excited Lomo to the point of verbal fighting. Question number 7. How does Lomo react when Chubuko says that he is not used to misbehavior by a young man like Lomo? So Lomo reacts by saying that Chubuko thinks that he is a fool. He says that he cannot talk to him calmly and politely, and he is making a false claim to his property. He further accuses Chubuko of being a grabber. Now, question number 8. Why does Natalia ask her father, Chubuko, to fetch Lomo in at once? Does she accuse her father? Natalia asked her father to fetch Lomo at once as She had come to know that Lomo had come to propose her. She accused Chibuko of driving Lomo out of their home. Question number 9. How does Natalia react when she comes to know that Lomo had come to propose? It has also been asked in CBSE 2014, as you can see. So when Natalia comes to know that Lomo had come there to propose her, she was shocked. She wails, changes her way of behaving, and asks her father to fetch Lomo. Okay. Now, long answer type questions, value based question. They are of 8 marks. Question number 1. The principle forgive and forget helps a lot in maintaining cordial relations with our neighbors. Do you think Anton Chekhov conveys this message in the play, The Proposal? Anton Chekhov does convey the message that the principle of forgive and forget helps a lot in maintaining cordial relationship with one's neighbors. Initially, the neighbors in the play, Natalia and Chibuko, were fighting over petty issues. They were putting important issues behind them and wasting their time by arguing over small things. These arguments slowly developed into fights, and they started hurling abuses at one another. This damaged their relationship with each other. It was when Natalia came to know that Lomo had come to propose her that she left the topic of argument behind. She also asked for forgiveness from Lomo and requested him to come to the point. Hence, it is mandatory to forgive and forget if one wants to have cordial relationship with others. Now, question number 2. The characters Natalia and Lomo lose their temper on trivial issues. It shows their poor skills at anger management. Suggest some ways that help you in maintaining cordial relationship with people around you. So the way in which Lomo and Natalia lost their temper shows that how anger can easily affect a relationship. Thus, it becomes very important to have good anger management skills. Following are a few anger management skills that can be followed in one's life. These would also help in building healthy relationship. Number one, always follow the principle of forgive and forget. Try to understand the person to whom you are talking. Be helpful rather than being self-centric. Always have empathy towards others. First, listen and then speak. It is a typing error. Be as courteous as possible to everyone. Don't have the habit of always complaining about others. Now, question number 3. Based on your understanding of the play, the proposal, how do you think good relationships can be maintained? Why in today's time we see so many people going away from each other? The play, the proposal, teaches us how anger and arguments can easily ruin the relationship. Thus, to maintain a good relationship, it is important to have a control over your anger. Having arguments over unimportant or small issues is extremely harmful and a waste of time. If someone commits a mistake, one should be ready to forgive and forget rather than being angry and arguing with the person endlessly. In today's time, people try to find only the positives in others and do not easily accept their negatives. Hence, it is becoming extremely difficult to maintain a good and cordial relationship with others. Question number 4. It is a common observance that more attention is paid to unimportant issues at the cost of important ones. The play, the proposal, beautifully portrayed this fact. Suggest some steps how we can avoid this unhealthy practice. It is true to an extent that people usually give more importance to the unimportant issues, forgetting their priorities, just like how Lomo came to propose Natalia, but due to their argument that a matter was left unaddressed. Thus it becomes very important to set your priorities in life. One must ignore the unimportant issues. It is a waste of time to have discussions over them. One should not pay too much attention on the trivialities. The energy can be saved on spending it over some useful and important issues that gives a fruitful result. Question number 5 is also been asked in CBSE examination 2015. Neighbors must have a cordial relationship which Lomu and Natalia do not have. Describe the first flight, describe the first fight between them. It has also been asked in CBSE examination 2015. Lomu and Natalia meet, and rather than proposing her, he gets off the point. He tells her how he inherited his land and how he respects her father. He also tells Natalia that his oxen meadows touch Natalia's birch woods. On hearing this, Natalia says that oxen meadows are theirs. They start arguing about it. Lomu clarifies that he is talking about the oxen meadows that are between her birch woods and burnt marsh. Natalia again insists that they are theirs. Lomu refuses it. He tells her that his aunt's grandmother gave those meadows in her father's grandfather. The peasants used the land for 40 years and started regarding it as their own. Natalia's father comes and also starts quarreling with Lomu. They get into a heated argument and resort to name calling. So it's all about the students, it's all about summary and questions regarding it. So you all must write down all the questions and rewrite their answers in your own words. Answers also have been shown on your screen. They are just model answer, so that you can get to know how to write write an answer, and also you can revise the chapter. So that is why answers are given here. But after going through the questions and answers, you should rewrite the answers in your own words. Make a PDF file of your practice notebook, and it should be sent on my mail. As of now, we have discussed 2 chapters of next revision test. In the next video, we will be practicing writing portion of your writing skills portion of your next revision test. So whatever is being discussed in the video, you must note them down and practice their answers. A few days are left in your examination. That is why this time you need to be very serious. Okay, dear students. So I hope you must have got the chapter and you must be practicing the question answers. So thank you, students, for watching this video. I'll see you tomorrow with a new topic.